Hi everyone, today we're going to see more components from the asset, and the first one is going to be the Feature Manager. This component allows us to enable or disable any feature in the asset. So for example, if you don't need to use the gravity power, you can disable it and after press the Set Configuration button. So now if we go to the Change Gravity component, we can see that this value is false. So if we play, we can see that the character can't use that power right now. If we enable it, we can use it. And for example, if you don't want that the player has the ability to run, use the aim mode, a shield, etc., you can disable this option here as you want. And here you press the button Set Configuration. And now if you go to the component of powers, you are going to see that most of the options that we are disabled here are disabled too. So if we set again to true, there enable again. And if for example you configure one option in the component in the script in the inspector directly like this, you can go to the Features Manager and press Get Current Configuration to get the current configuration of every component, just in the case you have configured individually that component. So if we press Get Current Configuration, we get the current configuration of the component. And now let's see the Input Manager component. This system allows us to define a list of different actions to make in the game, along with a button that is going to trigger that action. Like for example, jump is going to use the space button to be triggered, and jump is just the name that we have set to that action in concrete. Also, for every action, we can add a touch button element if we are going to make a game for mobile. But this field can be empty if you don't need it. So for example, this action hasn't a touch button. The load option is used when the game started, and we can select if the current controls loaded is going to be the file stored in the folder, or we are going to load the current configuration from this inspector. So currently the option selected is load file, so when the game started the game is going to load the access list from the file. So if we delete the list and press the button, we can see that the list is reloaded with the info stored in that file. However, if we select the load editor config and press the button play, the input list is going to be empty because there is any value in it. So now what we can do is press the default button to restore the default list of controls again. Also, what we can do is clear the list again and press the load from file button. But in this case, the load editor config has been to load file option. So now, if we press the button, the list is reloaded again in the inspector. So now, if we press the play button again, we can see that the current list of controls are currently working. Another configuration that we can use is to choose what are the current controls of the game if we are going to use the keyboard of a touch screen to play. Right now the current controls is the keyboard, but we can press the set touch control and we can see that the current control has been changed to mobile. So if we press play, we can see that the current controls used in the game is the touch controls. So you can use this to test every control in the game before that you compile the game to mobile. Also, in this mode, you can press the escape button and press switch control type to set the controls again for the keyboard. And now we can press set keyboard controls to change the current controls again to keyboard. These two options are only used to test the game while you are making it in the editor. You don't need to change the controls when you compile from PC or mobile. The asset checks what platform is being used when the game is being played. So if you compile the game for PC and start to play it, the code is going to check that the current platform is PC and change the controls to keyboard. In the other case, if the game is being played in a mobile with Android or iOS, it's going to check if the platform is a touch device and enable the touch control in this case. Finally, the last option that we can use is to add a new action for the list of inputs. So we can press the add new action. As you can see, a new action has been created and you can call it like you want. Let's call it new action. And we are going to use that key button to trigger it. For now, we are not going to use a touch button. So now what we can do is go into the code. So here you can see what we need to use that new input. We need the input manager component, and in the start of the game we need to find the character game object and inside of it the input manager component. So now in update or in any updated function, we are going to define this code. So here we are going to call the function getButton, the name of the action, and what type of key press we are going to use. For example, getKeyDown, getKey, or getKeyUp. It works like the default code from the Unity. So for example, if you only want to call the code inside the new action just once, when the key is being pressed or released, you only need this code or this code. However, if you need a button that is going to call a code while you keep press that button, you're going to use this code. You can use these three type of buttons at the same time, like we are going to see right now. So now what we can do is attach that new script to any game object of the scene and press the play button. So this code is only going to show a message in this console. So let's see how it works. So now, as you can see, nothing happens, but this is due to we have defined a new action, but we have not saved that new action. And like you can see, the load option is load from file. So we are not loading from the inspector. We are loading the info from the file stored in the folder. And you can see that here the new action element is lost. So what you can do is to select the option load editor config to load the current controls configured in the inspector, or press the Save to File button to save this current configuration in the file. What we are going to do is select the Load File option and press the Save to File button. And now you can see that when the key has been pressed, it shows an only message, and I am holding the key right now, and you can see that a message is being showing. And when I release the key, a new message is showing again. And if we press again, you can see how the message increases. And here in the inspector, you can see that the new action defined is skipped in the inspector. One thing that you can see when you define a new action for an input button is that when you press the edit control input, you can see here the list of every input defined, and here you can see that the new action has to be added to it because this menu is built when the game starts. This menu also allows us to configure the current control buttons for every action in game. So we can press, for example, jump and use a new key button to trigger it. And we press the save button. So now when we press the L, the player jumps. And this configuration is saved from game to game. But if we see here the jump action, we can see that the key button still being the space button. This is due to these values are the previous one before we have saved the new configuration. So if we press the load from file, we can see now that the action jump has the new key button. And if we press the play button and check the edit control input menu, we can see how the jump action has that new button that we have configured. So now, what if you need to add a new touch button for that new action? So what you have to do is going to add a menus, touch panel, let's enable it, and add a new button. You need to call this button like the action defined in the input manager. In other case, it's not going to work. So let's call it new action. Assign it in the field. Disable this again. But before try it, you need to add a piece of code in the script. So here, what we need to add is this. In case that the keyboard has been pressed or the touch button, call it new action, has been pressed. And like the keyboard control, we need to call it like get key down, get key, or get key up. So what we can do is add this code to the other checks and change the type of button. And now we can test it. So like you can see, the keyboard controls still works, and if we change the control to touch and we press this button, you can see how the messages are showed too. When we press, when we hold the button, and when we release. So now, what if you want to remove a new button defined? What you can do is configure directly the size of the list, like this, or press the default button to restore the default list controls. In the next update, I'm going to add an option to remove every button one by one, so this configuration won't be needed in the next version of the asset. Finally, you can notice these values here, used to configure the sensitivity of the touch control and the mouse in a game. So if we press the play button and go to the configure menu, you can see how the values are configured. And if we set the mouse sensitivity to 2, you can notice how the camera moves faster than before. And the same happens with the joysticks. So if we configure the right value and change the control, we can see that the right joystick moves the camera faster than before. So this is all for now. See you.